Following is a class on the Srimad Bhagavatam, 7th canto, 9th chapter, text number 13, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded in August of 1968 in Montreal, Canada.
Now Somnath Thakur is offering his prayer to the Lord. Aha Prabhu Nanda Sutta. Mrikhavānu sutājuta. My dear Lord, the son of King Nanda, Krishna's foster father's name was Nanda Maharaj. So he is very much pleased when he is addressed as the son of Nanda. He is the original person. He has no father, but he accepts his devotee as his father. He accepts his devotee as man. He is full in himself, but still he awaits the affection of father and mother. This is the beauty of Krishna. So he takes pleasure when he is addressed as Nanda Sutta, as Radha Raman, like that. So, Narottam Das Thakur is addressing, my dear Lord, the son of Nanda, and Vrishabhanu Sutta Juta, and present with the daughter of King Vrishabhanu. Radharani's father was Vrishabhanu. He was also king. So, Krishna and Radha is combined, and the devotee is addressing, my dear son of Nanda, you are now united with the daughter of Vrishabhanu. Karuna karahaiva. Now you bestow your mercy upon this fallen soul. Narottama Dasakaya. This prayer is offered by Narottama Das Thakur, the great acharya of the Vaishnava Sampradaya. He is saying for himself, my dear Lord, don't kick me away. Narottama Dasakaya Nathaliya Nanapa. Don't kick me out. Accept me. In the service of your lotus feet. Tumi vina kriyasyama. I have no other shelter than yours. This is the sum and substance of all prayer. If you submit to the Lord that I have no other shelter than yourself, then he takes advanced charge of it. But if you think that my dear Lord or my dear God, I come to you for my daily bread, and as soon as you give me my daily bread, my business is finished with you. No. That is also very good. But this is not love. This is business. The Krishna wants lover, not for any business. And Prahlada Maharaj was offered benediction by the Lord. My dear Prahlada, now whatever you want, you can ask from me. Prahlada Maharaj said, my dear Lord, you are so opulent and I am so poor. And I am addicted to this material enjoyment. You are offering me whatever you want, you can take from me. Just imagine, Suppose I am a poor man, and if a rich man says, Swamiji, whatever millions of dollars you want, you can ask them. Then I shall put my claim a big, very big amount. Oh, here is a great opportunity. But when Prahlada Maharaj refused, Prahlada Maharaj said, my dear Lord, it is my duty to render service unto you, not in exchange of something gain. Oh, I am not a merchant that I am doing this. Manik Vritti. So the Lord was very satisfied. That is the way of pure devotion. That was taught by Lord Chaitanya. Na dhanang na janang na sundaring kavitang ma jagadishakang. My dear Lord, I do not ask from you any amount of wealth, na dhanang, na janang, neither any number of followers, because every one of us, we want to be the richest man in the world, the greatest leader of the world, and to have a very beautiful wife. This is our heart's desire in the material world. So, control over a vast mass of people, I want to be prime minister, president, or political leader, Hitler or Gandhi, like that, and to amass mass of wealth. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, no, I don't want all this. This is prayer. Na dhanang, na janang, na sundaring kavitang va jagadisa kamai. Then what for you have come to me? Mama janmani janmani ishare bhavatad bhakti rahaitu kitai. My dear Lord, I pray that birth after birth, I may have unconditional, causeless devotion unto you. Not devotion for some purpose. That is not your devotion. If you have got some purpose, that is of course accepted in the Bhagavad Gita, that if anyone goes to Lord to pray something, with purpose, that is also good, but that is not pure. Pure devotee never asks anything from the Lord. That is pure devotion. So Prahlada Maharaj was a pure devotee. Therefore, he does not make any business with God. That I offer you my prayer to take something from you. We shall discuss this prayer of Prahlada Maharaj one after another, and in none of the paragraphs you will find that Prahlada Maharaj is asking something, give me this for my sense gratification. No. This is the sign of your devotion. So he says, Mahi Grinami, I shall simply, you can pray, anyone can pray. It does not require an education. If you simply feel, oh, God is so great, He has created this sun, He has created this moon, oh, He has created this ocean, He has created this air, He has created so many fruits, so many flowers. Go on. You don't require any, because simply try to understand how great God is. There is no other education required. In the Bhagavad Gita, the Lord says, Prabhasmi Sasishurja. He says that I am the test in the water. Who does not take water? The water is our life. So when you take water, quench your thirst, you can immediately thank God, because that taste is God. So immediately you can remember, oh my dear Lord, you have created so nice thing, water. Oh, I am so thirsty, it is quenching my thirst. Thanks. Is it very difficult? But the nonsense they will not do even this. They say, oh, God is dead. Therefore you are suffering. We are so ungrateful that we even do not give thanks in the ordinary way. If somebody gives me a glass of water when I am thirsty, it is etiquette. I say, thank you. As the God has given us so vast mass of water in the ocean, in the sea, in the sky, without water we cannot live, there is no thanksgiving. There is no thanksgiving. Rather we say, God is dead. There are so much profuse light for this electric light. We are paying bill to the electric company, and God is supplying so much light in the night as moon and the daytime as sun. Prabhasmi sasusurjaya. Sasusurjaya means moon, and surja means sun. So He is supplying so much light, everything, whatever you require, and there is no thanksgiving. So only one has to become grateful. Prahlada Maharaj says that I don't require to be very educated or a learned scholar in Sanskrit or any other language and very poetic, so that I have to offer my prayers in a beautiful language, and God may be pleased by the poetic idea. Just like some mundane poet thinks that they imagine some poetic ideas and thereby God is pleased. No. Bhaktya tutoso tutosa bhagavan gadaju sapaya. The God can be pleased only by the feeling of your love. That is required. But anyone can do that, provided he feels the gratitude, the God is so kind. So Prahlada Maharaj says, Nicho jaya guna visagga anupravishtya kuyeta jina hi pumana anuvarnitena. Now, God is so kind that He is giving you light, air, everything that you require for your existence. Either you give Him thanks or you do not give Him thanks, the supply will be there. But somebody says, then what is the use of giving Him thanks? The use is for yourself. What is that? Prahlada Maharaj says, ja, puyeta jena puman anuvarnitena. If I give thanks to Lord, then I become purified. God does not wait for your thanks. He has already created. But if you give thanks, then you become purified. Oh. What is that purification? The purification is that gradually you become liberated from the influence of the materialistic modes. There are three modes of material nature. Somebody is in the modes of goodness, somebody is in the modes of passion, somebody is in the modes of ignorance. But in the Bhagavad Gita it is said, Mantyabhyavicharini bhakti yogi na jasevate. Anyone who is engaged in transcendental loving service, sa gunan samathita etan, he transcends the influence of these modes of material nature, and brahma bhuyaya kalpate, he becomes brahma liyala. We are already Brahma, but we have to realize. And as soon as we realize Brahma Bhuta Prasannatma, as soon as we realize Brahma, immediately we become anxiety-less. Prasannatma. So it is for me. We are always suffering with anxiety. Beginning from President Johnson down to the small ant, or beginning from the greatest living creature, Brahma, down to the ant, everyone is anxious. That is material consciousness. And to become free from anxiety is to become Krishna consciousness. So if you want to be benefited, what is that benefit? The benefit is to become anxiety-less, that's all. Just like this little child, he is anxiety-less because he is confident that there is his father, his mother, and they will protect him. He doesn't care for anybody. He's free. So that is the stage of your Krishna consciousness. Not that you shall become a foolish, but the Krishna consciousness is so nice that you will be happy. You will be happy in the feeling, there is my protector. There is my protector. There is one nice prayer by Jamunacha. He says, Prahasayame sanatu jivita. Manorathena. I just remember. Sanatu jivita. Kada prahasayashyami sanatu jivita. Bhavantamevam charan nirantaram prasantam nishesa gato manantaram. He says, Bhavantamevam charan nirantaram. My dear Lord, when I shall be always engaged in Krishna consciousness? Bhavantamevam charan nirantaram. Nirantaram means incessantly, without any partition. That this much I am worldly conscious and this much I am Krishna conscious. No. Simply Krishna conscious. Bhavantameva charan nirantaram. How can we show Krishna consciousness? Na prasanta nishesa manorathantaram. I shall finish altogether all concoction of my mind. Everything is creating different consciousness by the concoction of mind. Sometimes I am feeling, I shall become a great businessman. Or I shall become the president. I shall become the minister. Or I shall become this and that. So many. The mind is always agitated. I shall possess that thing, I shall possess that thing, I shall kill him, I shall finish him. So, these are called mental hallucinations. So, one has to become completely free from this mental hallucination or craziness. Then one can be fixed up in Krishna consciousness. So, bhavantameva charan nirantaram prasanta. Prashanta means prakṣṭa rūpeṇa śānta. Śānta means peaceful. Completely peaceful. Bhavantam eva charam nirantaram prashanta nishesa monorathantaram kadāham oikāntika nitta kinkara. This can be achieved when we constantly engage ourselves, our mind, our body, our action, our words, simply for Krishna. Simply for Krishna. If you talk for Krishna. If you eat for Krishna. If you sleep for Krishna. If you work for Krishna. All that. Bhavantameva charam nirantaram prashanta nishesa manorathantaram kadaham oikantika nitta kinkara. Nitta means eternally. Kinkara means servant. So her says, Shami, oh, you are becoming servant, how you can be happy? Yes. How one can be happy by servant, becoming servant? There are many instances. Suppose you are working in a private farm. Fortunately, you get a very good job in the government service, where there are so many regulations, you get pension, you get this, that. So everyone aspires to get some government service, and he becomes satisfied. So if you can become satisfied by becoming a government servant, how much satisfied you will be, just imagine, by becoming the servant of the Supreme Government. Krishna. What is this government? A teeny government. But don't you know how big government is this? This planetary system is running on, the sun is rising in due course, the moon is rising in due course, there is seasonal changes. There are so many demigods, innumerable living entities, their foodstuff is being supplied, it is being produced in different planets, different varieties. So there is a huge, big government of Krishna. If you become a servant of that big government, how much you will be satisfied? Just imagine. If you can become satisfied by serving this teeny government, why not become satisfied being the servant of the Supreme God? So, to become servant of Krishna or God is the supreme satisfaction. It is not that that service is very valuable service. Sanatha jivita. Sanatha jivita means that service is not ended only few minutes notice. Just like government servant cannot be dismissed simply by saying, oh, don't come tomorrow. Don't come. So, if government service cannot be terminated so whimsically, how Krishna's service can be terminated whimsically? No. So as soon as you become servant of Krishna, you get full satisfaction. Sanatha-ji. Sanatha-jivita means, he'll understand that I have a master who is so full, who is so complete, who is so competent, who is so faithful, and who is so nice. There is no injustice. Therefore, those who are mendicants, they are so much confident that Krishna will provide for my subsistence. Krishna will abhaya. Therefore they are not fearful. Abhayam satya saṃsuddhi. In the Bhagavad Gita you'll find that one has to attain to that state. No fearfulness. Fearfulness is due to our absorption in the material consciousness. Vayam vidyādhi nivesatasyāt īśādapetasyab viparjayasmiti. Because we have got a different consciousness, therefore we are fearful. If you are Krishna conscious, then we can never be fearful. Narayana parasadve na kudashana vidyati. One who is in Krishna consciousness, he is not afraid of anything. Several times I have given you this example, especially Lord Jesus Christ. He was not fearful when he was punished to be crucified. He never cared for it. So, there are many examples in the history, in the scriptures, that those who are Krishna conscious or God conscious, they are not fearful. But Lord Maharaj himself, he was 5 years old boy, and his father was teasing him. You cannot become Krishna conscious. Who is Krishna? 86. You cannot do that. This is my order. He several times pleaded, my dear father, why you are talking like this? You are also servant of Krishna. So he never cared for it. Ultimately he wanted to kill his 5 years old boy, and Lord Nrisimhadev appeared. And this prayer is in connection with that. So, Prahlada Maharaj is beginning his prayer. Sarve dhami vidikarat sabasattva dhamno brahmadaya vamibhisa nachat vijantya shimaya bhutaya utatma sukhaya chasya vikritam bhagavato vitidavatari. So, he is praying, my dear Lord, we hear the demigods are present. The demigods means Brahma, Lord Shiva, Anarat, Indra, they all have come here because we have appeared. So, they are not troublesome like my father. They are not troublesome because my father was a demon. So he was against always against God. But these demigods, they are not like my father. So you pacify yourself. Now my father is killed. That business is finished. Now these people, they will never create any trouble. They will become pacified. That is the difference between the demons and demigods. There are two classes of living creatures, always. Either in this planet or any planet within this universe, there are two classes of living creatures. One is called the demon, and the other is called the demigod. What is the difference? The demigods are godly. They accept the existence of God. They obey the orders of God. They act in God consciousness or Krishna consciousness, whereas the demons, they don't believe in God. They defy God's regulation and they want to become imitation God. So Hiranyakasipu was that type of demon, whereas Brahma and others, they are not that. So Prahlada Maharaj is saying, that he is a ami udvijanta vidhyata sarve brahmadaya sattamutra. Now, because you have appeared in so fearful appearance, these persons, these demigods, they have become afraid. So they are your devotees. So for their pacification, please, you also become pacified.